got to make up your mind, I'm not staying here. Hallelujah. If you want it, there's going to be a price tag to it. He said, you would receive it if you are there when I depart. When I go up, you're going to have to be there. You're going to have to be with me. Everywhere I go, you don't know when I'm leaving. You don't know where I'm going. But you're going to have to be there everywhere that I go. And so everywhere that Elijah went, Elisha was there. I'm staying with you. I'm staying with you. I'm not staying here at Bethel. I'm not staying at Gilgal. I'm not staying at Jericho, the place of plenty. But I'm going with you because I want what you've got. We've got to make up in our minds that I don't care what happens, I've got to stay with him. I got to stay close to him. Hallelujah. There has to be a special love for God that you will not let anything take away. There's got to be a special place in your heart that nothing else can get there. This is reserved for God. I don't care what other people say. I don't care what kind of advice they give me. I don't care what's going on. I want God more than anything else in my life. And I need him. Even Elijah tested Elisha. Why don't you stay here? The sons of the prophets, everywhere they went, they all discouraged him. Oh, he's leaving you. Why don't you just stay here with us? Why don't you just compromise with us? Why don't you just come over here? It's a little bit easier over here. No, if you want what he's got, you've got to stay with him. If you want what he has for you, you've got to stay by his side. No matter what you go with, no matter what you go through, you've got to keep your relationship with God. Your relationship with God is more important than success in your ministry. It's more important than singing in the choir. It's more important than singing a solo. It's more important than preaching. It's more important than any kind of ministry that you can have. Because you can lose your walk with God and you've lost it. You've lost it all. Your relationship with God is more important in your life. Matthew 5:8 says, blessed are the pure in heart. Without a pure heart, you won't see God. Without a pure heart, you won't see God. The Bible tells us that Saul prophesied even after God had rejected him. Caiaphas, he prophesied why his goal was to kill Jesus. He prophesied. I'm preaching about you need to stay with him. You don't need to be a minister of him or be in the ministry is not the most important. Whatever your ministry may be, whatever area your ministry may be, but being with him and knowing who he is, that is most important in your life. My calling, my relationship, my commitment is the most important thing. I want us to stand tonight. Elisha received the double portion. Elisha saw many miracles. Elisha, after the mantle, the anointing was on his life and God was blessing his life. What would have happened if he would have stayed at Gilgal with all the rest of the prophets? What would have happened if he would have stayed at any of the points that they'd asked him to? He would have not have received the double portion. But when Elisha picked that up and the Spirit of God was on him, he struck those waters after Elijah had gone up. And he struck those waters. And the same God of Elijah was now the God of Elisha. And wherever he went, God was with him. And when a widow needed some food, God provided it. Four kings were counseled by Elisha. He destroyed 42 tormentors by cursing them. He multiplied the oil of an impoverished widow. He healed a barren woman. He raised a dead boy to life. He multiplied food. He cured Naaman of leprosy. And I'm talking about with the Spirit of God moving in him. Leprosy came on Gehazi. An axe head swam because of what he said. He told the king of Israel that the king of Syria, what he was saying in his bedchamber. He said, this is what he's saying. God told me. He opened the eyes of his servant. He blinded a whole army and then opened their eyes again. I'm talking about what God can do in your life. Yes, yes, yes. But you can just stay where you're at and you'll never see any of it. You can just stay where you're at and you may be comfortable. But I'm here to let you know that salvation is not about vacation. It's about a destination. It's not about sitting and enjoying the sights, but it's about working in His kingdom. It's about answering His call. It's about loving souls. It's about moving with Him. We've got to determine in our heart, in our spirit, I'm not staying here. I can't stay here any longer. I can't stay here and look at unbelief. I can't live in wrong circumstance. I can't live without faith. I can't stay here in mediocrity. I can't stay any longer with a lack of burden for souls. But I got to keep moving. I got to have more of you. I got to be with you. If you want God to move in your life, if you want to affirm God in your life, this altar is open tonight. I can't stay here. I've got to keep moving spiritually. I've got to attain what you have for my life. I want more of you.